تفضل يا شيخ.
بسم الله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد، نعود إلى الفوائد من قصة موسى وهارون عليهما السلام، وقد أنهينا الفائدة 22.
We go back to the benefits of the story from the story of Musa and Harun, and we reached benefit number 22.
ذكرنا في الفائدة 22 أن الأنبياء لا ننظر إلى المعجزات فقط التي أتوا
we
بها.
We mentioned in the benefit number 22 that regarding the prophets, we don't only look on and consider the miracles that they came with.
بل ننظر لكي نؤمن بهم إيمانا يقينيا.
Rather, we also consider in order for us to believe in them a belief with certainty.
ننظر إلى صفاتهم وأخلاقهم.
We look into their qualities and their moral or behavior.
ننظر إلى ما جاءوا به من شريعة ودين.
We look at the law and the religion that they came with.
ننظر إلى نصر الله لهم بالحجة والبيان.
We look at and we consider the fact that Allah supports them with proof and evidence and clarification.
فهم بالحجة والبيان منصورون دائما.
So they are with evidence and clarification, they are always supported.
أما بالقوة فأحيانا وأحيانا.
As for with power and might, then sometimes they are victorious, sometimes they don't.
ننظر كذلك إلى بشارة الأنبياء السابقين لهم.
Likewise, we consider the fact that the previous prophets, they may anticipate or they may give the good news of the coming of those prophets.
كذلك نستطيع أن نطبق بعض هذه الصفات على من نريد أن نأخذ منهم الفتوى والتعليم في الدين.
Likewise, we can apply those qualities to the people that we seek from them religious verdicts, and we seek from them learning the religion. We learn the religion from them.
الذين يتكلمون باسم الإسلام كثيرون.
Those who speak in the name of Islam, they are so many.
ولكن علينا أن نختار منهم التقاة الراسخين في العلم الثقات.
But it is upon us to choose the people of piety amongst them, those who are firmly grounded in knowledge, those who are trustworthy.
ولهذا يقول سعيد بن المسيب رحمه الله تعالى.
This is why سعيد بن المسيب رحمه الله تعالى says.
إن هذا العلم دين.
Surely this religion is this knowledge is religion is deen.
فانظروا إلى من تأخذون منه دينكم.
So look and consider who you take your religion from.
فإذا أردنا أن نأخذ العلم والفتوى من إنسان يدعو إلى الإسلام.
So if we wanted to take knowledge and religious verdicts, fatwa from those who call to Islam,
فلا يكفي أن ننظر أنه فصيح اللسان فقط.
We don't just suffice ourselves with the fact that he is very good. He has a good command in terms of talking. He is eloquent in speech.
أو أنه يأتي بالأدلة الكثيرة على ما يدعو إليه.
Or that he actually presents a lot of proofs for the things that he is calling to.
بل ننظر إلى أخلاقه وسيرته.
Rather, we look at his manners and his biography, the way he conducts himself.
ننظر إلى صلاته.
We look at his prayer.
هل هو محافظ عليها؟
Is he keeping his duty towards his prayers?
هل يصليها كما يجب؟
Is he praying like he is commanded?
كذلك ننظر إلى ما يدعو إليه.
Likewise, we consider what he is calling to.
هل يوافق ما كان عليه الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام؟
Does it agree with what the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was upon?
هل يوافق ما كان عليه السلف الصالح؟
Does it agree with what the pious predecessors used to be upon?
هل يوافق العلماء المعاصرين الثقات؟
Is he in agreement with the contemporary scholars that are trustworthy؟
أو أنه يأتي بفتاوى غريبة؟
Or is he someone who brings odd religious verdicts؟
تحدث strange ones. البلبلة والفتنة.
Strange verdicts that cause confusion and turmoil.
إذن لابد أن ننظر إلى هذه الصفات حتى نأخذ العلم عن هذا الإنسان.
So we have to look at and consider these qualities so that we will take knowledge from this person.
يعني أنا لأننا نسمع ونرى كثير من الناس خاصة في هذه الوسائل الجديدة التواصل الاجتماعي.
That is because we hear from a lot of people regarding those more of the social media, Facebook and otherwise, many people are talking. So we have to make sure who we are taking our religion from.
فيكونون لا يأتون بالغرائب والأشياء التي يتعجب
منها الناس. They should be people that do not bring strange things and things that the people wonder at.
ولا يخالفون العلماء المعاصرين.
And they don't oppose the contemporary scholars.
فأعطيكم مثالا.
I give you an example.
بعض الشباب في بعض البلاد الإسلامية وغير الإسلامية.
Some young people in Muslim countries and non-Muslim countries.
يقول أنا لن أعطي التطعيمات لأولادي.
I will not do the for my kids vaccinations.
قيل له لماذا؟ قال لأن نحن نداوي المرض قبل أن ينزل المرض.
They said to him, "Why is that?" He said, "We do not treat the sickness before it comes."
فماذا نقول له؟
So what do we say to him?
نقول له إن العلماء المعاصرين هل يطعمون أولادهم؟
We say that the contemporary scholars, the scholars who are living with us now, do they vaccinate their children or no?
هل يسمحون لأولادهم لأولاد المسلمين بذلك؟
Do they allow the Muslim children to have that, to vaccinate?
الجواب نعم.
The answer is yes.
وهذه التطعيمات شيء جديد.
And those vaccinations, they are a new thing.
فنقول لهم أيها الشباب لا تفهموا الدين وحدكم.
We say to them, oh youth, do not try to understand the religion on your own.
افهموا الدين كما يفهمه هؤلاء العلماء المعاصرون.
Understand the religion like the contemporary scholars understand it.
بعض الناس يقول أنا سأسكن في بيت من طين وليس فيه البلاط وليس فيه الكهرباء كما كان الناس في الماضي.
Someone will say, I will live in a house made of clay, يعني mud and clay. من الطين ليس فيه ماذا يا شيخ؟
البلاط.
It doesn't have the tiles.
وليس فيه الكهرباء.
No electricity in it.
وليس فيه الماء مع في العين
and no water faucets. No water faucet in it.
فنقول له إن العلماء المعاصرين يفهمون الدين أحسن منك.
So we say that our scholars nowadays they understand the religion better than you.
وهم يسكنون في مثل هذه البيوت
and they live
المعاصرة.
In the likes of these modern homes.
إذن عليك أن تفهم الدين كما يفهمه هؤلاء العلماء أكبر منك في العلم أكبر منك في السن.
So you must understand the religion like those scholars understand it. Those who are senior to you in terms of age and senior to you in knowledge and understanding.
إذا حدثت مشكلة في العالم.
If a problem happens around the world,
فالإنسان ينظر ماذا يقول العلماء المعاصرون في هذه المشكلة المعاصرة الجديدة.
So he would look at and consider what the contemporary scholars say regarding this new problem that happened.
لأن الله تعالى من حكمته أنه لا يجمع أمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم على ضلالة.
Because from the wisdom of Allah سبحانه وتعالى is that he will not have the Muslim ummah, the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will not have them unanimously agree on something that is a misguidance.
إذا كان مثلا خرج بيننا رجل يدعو إلى الإسلام.
So if there came out amongst us someone who calls to Islam.
واشتهر بين الناس.
And he became famous within the people.
فعلينا أن ننظر إلى أخلاقه.
We have to look at his morals, his manners.
ننظر إلى دعوته هل تجمع أو تحدث البلبلة والفتنة.
We look at his call. Does it unite the people or it causes confusion and turmoil?
هل يوافق العلماء المعاصرين أم يخرج عن تعاليمهم وفهمهم؟
Is he in agreement with the other scholars, the contemporary scholars, or is he outside of their understanding?
بهذا يكون عندنا الميزان الذي نعرف به المحق من المبطل.
How we have this scale, we have this yardstick by which we can tell who is upon right and who is upon falsehood.
الفائدة 23.
Benefit 23.
قال الله تعالى أن موسى قال لله وأن الله تعالى قال لموسى ولقد مننا عليك مرة أخرى.
الله سبحانه وتعالى said that. He said, and surely we have favored you another time. Allah says to Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام, we favored you another time.
الله تعالى بيّن لموسى أن إرسال الله له من أعظم النعم.
إحسان الله.
إرسال.
Allah clarified to Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام that sending him as a messenger is from the greatest favors and bounties.
فوجود الأنبياء وفي خاتمتهم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نعمة من الله على البشر.
The fact that Allah sends prophets, that they exist, and the last and seal is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is a favor from Allah to humanity.
فعلينا أن نشكر الله تعالى على نعمة إرسال الأنبياء.
So we must thank Allah عز وجل for the bounty of him sending prophets.
لأن هؤلاء الأنبياء يرشدوننا إلى الخير في الدنيا والآخرة.
For these prophets, they guide us to goodness in this worldly life and the next life.
وخاصة رسول الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Especially the messenger of Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
الذي أرشد الناس.
The one who guided the people.
إلى ما يصلحهم.
To that which rectifies and reforms them.
وإلى ما يزكيهم ويطهرهم.
And guided them to what purifies and sanctifies them.
قال الله تعالى.
الله تعالى said.
لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم.
Surely Allah عز وجل has favored the believers when He sent within them a messenger from within themselves.
يتلو عليهم آياته.
Reciting to them his book, his verses.
ويزكيهم.
And purifying them.
ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة.
And teaching them the book and the wisdom.
وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين.
Yet they were before in manifest misguidance or error.
فبعثة نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نعمة عظمى.
The sending of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is a great favor.
لأنه به أخرجنا الله تعالى من الظلمات إلى النور.
Because through him Allah عز وجل extracted us, took us out from the darknesses to light.
الفائدة 24.
Benefit 24.
في قوله تعالى وأقم الصلاة لذكري.
In the statement of Allah تعالى perform or establish the prayer for my remembrance.
بين الله تعالى المقصود من الصلاة هنا هو ذكر الله تعالى.
Allah عز وجل clarified here what is meant by salah, and that is to remember Allah عز وجل.
ومنه نفهم الحكمة في توزيع الله للصلوات الخمس على طول النهار والليل.
And from that we understand the wisdom of Allah سبحانه وتعالى in distributing the prayers throughout the day and night.
ذلك لكي نذكر الله ولا نغفل.
That is so that we will always remember Allah and we will not be negligent or heedless.
ولذلك لم يجعل الله تعالى مثلا الصلوات الخمس في الصباح فقط أو
this
في الليل فقط.
This is why Allah did not legislate the five prayers only in the morning or in the evening only.
بل جعلها موزعة في اليوم والليلة.
Rather, Allah made those prayers distributed over night and day.
حتى نذكر الله تعالى ولا نكون من الغافلين.
So that we will always remember Allah and we will not be from those who are negligent or unaware of Allah.
الفائدة 25.
Benefit 25.
الله تعالى قال لموسى وهارون
الله تعالى said to موسى and هارون
اذهب أنت وأخوك بآياتي ولا تنيا في ذكري
Go you and your brother with my signs, with my verses, and do not be delayed, do not be held back from my remembrance. Always remember me and don't slow down.
بين الله لهما أن ذكر الله يساعدهم على الدعوة إلى الله خاصة أمام الجبابرة.
الله عز وجل informed them here that the remembrance of Allah will strengthen and fortify them to invite others to Allah, especially when they are inviting, when you invite the tyrants.
فقوة ذكر الله تعين الداعية إلى الله.
Being strong in remembering Allah. This will help the caller to Allah.
على تحمل أعباء الدعوة إلى الإسلام.
It will help him to endure the different loads and duties in calling to Allah.
وقد رتب الصحابة رضي الله تعالى عنهم لصور المصحف في عهد عثمان رضي الله عنه على شيء من ذلك.
مرة أخرى يا شيخ.
فقد جعلوا سورة المزمل قبل سورة المدثر
So the companions رضي الله عنهم they organized the way the chapters of the Quran are in the Mus'haf for a wisdom. For instance, سورة المزمل is before سورة المدثر
ففي سورة المزمل أمره الله تعالى بقيام الليل وذكر الله
الله عز وجل commanded him to Remember Allah, to perform night prayer and to do tasbih, glorification of Allah عز وجل.
ثم سورة المدثر أمرته بإنذار الناس وتبليغهم.
Then سورة المدثر commanded him عليه الصلاة والسلام to warn the people and to call them.
إذن ذكر الله يساعد الإنسان على النجاح في دعوته إلى الإسلام.
The remembrance of Allah helps the person to succeed in his call to Allah.
إن ترتيب السور في المصحف فعله الصحابة بحكمة.
Organizing how the order of the chapters of the Quran, the companions they did that for wisdom.
فمثلا جعلوا سورة يونس بعد سورة التوبة.
For instance, سورة يونس they made it after سورة التوبة.
لتنبيه الناس إلى أن يونس قد تاب الله عليه.
To bring the attention of the people that يونس الله عز وجل has facilitated and accepted his repentance.
وهكذا فإن الصحابة لما رتبوا المصحف على هذا النحو
so
لحكمة.
When the companions they put the order of the chapters of the Quran, they did that for a wisdom.
الفائدة 26.
Benefit 26.
موسى عليه السلام قبل أن يذهب إلى دعوة فرعون دعا بهذا الدعاء.
موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام before going to call Pharaoh he made دعاء with this these words
قال رب اشرح لي صدري
he said oh Allah open up for me my chest
رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري
make my chest comfortable and make easy for me my affair
واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي
and untie the knot from my tongue so that they will understand my statement
فانشراح الصدر
for the chest to be comfortable to be serene
والبعد عن الحزن
and to be away from sadness
والفصاحة والبيان
and being able to clarify your words and to and be eloquent in your speech
تساعد على النجاح في الدعوة إلى الله
this will help one to succeed in calling to Allah
إذن الإنسان قبل أن يدعو إلى الإسلام so عليه أن يكثر من ذكر الله.
The person before calling to Islam, he must, it is upon him to remember Allah much.
عليه أن يحافظ على الصلاة.
And it is upon him to keep his duty to the prayer.
وعليه أن يدعو الله تعالى بانشراح الصدر والتيسير.
And he should call upon Allah to have his chest be comfortable and to make things easy for him.
مثلا إذا كنت ستتكلم مع إنسان تدعوه إلى الإسلام
so
فأكثر من الاستغفار قبل أن تجلس معه
to talk to someone about Islam do a lot of استغفار seeking forgiveness before you sit with him to invite him
أكثر من ذكر الله
remember Allah much
فإن الله سيعينك
for Allah will help you
ويجعل كلامك واضحا.
And he will make your words be clear.
الفائدة السابعة والعشرون.
Benefit 27.
قال موسى عليه السلام واجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي هارون أخي.
موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام he said and have for me a supporter, a helper from my family, هارون my brother.
في هذه الآية بيان لفضل موسى عليه السلام وأنه كان يحب الخير لأخيه.
In this ayah, it clarifies the excellent virtues of Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام that he wanted good for his brother.
حتى قيل ما بر أخ أخاه كما بر موسى أخاه هارون إذ طلب له أشرف مطلب وهو الرسالة والنبوة.
To a point that they said, the scholars said that there is no one who was righteous and kind to his brother like Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام was to his brother. For out of his kindness, he asked for him the prophethood.
فإذا آتاك الله تعالى علما في الدين.
So if Allah granted you knowledge in the religion.
واستقامة على الدين.
And steadfastness upon the religion.
فادع لإخوانك بمثل ذلك.
So make dua for your brothers to have the same like that.
هذا دليل على سلامة الصدر من الحسد.
And this is a proof that your chest is completely free and is sound, free from envy.
قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. متفق عليه.
None of you truly believes until he loves for his brother what he loves for himself. Agreed upon by Bukhari and Muslim.
إذن على الإنسان أن يحب الخير لإخوانه.
So it is upon the person to love the goodness for his brothers.
وليس الخير في أمور الدنيا فقط بل في أمور الدين.
Not just wanting good for them in the worldly matters, rather also in the religious matters.
الفائدة السابعة والعشرون.
Benefit 27.
في قول موسى عليه السلام كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا.
In the statement of موسى عليه السلام so that we will glorify you with tasbih. Much and so that we will remember you much or a lot.
طلب من الله أن يجعل هارون معه نبيا.
الله عز وجل to make Harun a prophet alongside with him.
لكي يتعاون معه على الدعوة إلى الله.
So that they will help one another to call and invite to Allah.
ويتعاون معه على ذكر الله.
And so that they will cooperate with one another to remember Allah.
ففي هذا فضل التعاون على الخير.
In this we understand or we benefit the excellence of cooperation upon goodness.
وأن المؤمن ضعيف بنفسه قوي بأخيه.
That the believer is actually weak by himself alone. He is strong with his brother alongside with him.
فيدعو الله تعالى أن يسخر له من يعينه على الخير والدعوة إلى الخير.
So he calls upon Allah عز وجل to facilitate, to subject and subjugate for him someone who will help him to call to Allah and to do good.
وقد أيد الله رسوله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بأصحابه.
And Allah عز وجل supported his messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم with his companions.
قال تعالى هو الذي أيدك بنصره وبالمؤمنين.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى said he is the one سبحانه وتعالى he is the one who supported you with his victory, with his support and with the believers.
فعلى المسلم أن يحرص على إخوانه ويتعاون معهم
so
على الخير.
So it is upon the believer to the Muslim to be very careful about his friends and that he should cooperate with them upon goodness.
الفائدة الثامنة والعشرون.
Benefit 28.
على الدعاة إلى الإسلام أن يفرحوا بوجود من يدعو مثلهم إلى الإسلام.
It is upon the callers to Islam to be happy that there are other callers to Islam as well.
وليحذروا من التحاسد بينهم والتباغض.
Let them be warned and cautious against envy between themselves and having animosity towards one another.
لأن ذلك الحسد والتباغض يفسد حسناتهم ويمحوها.
Because that envy and animosity will wipe out and destroy, erase all of their good deeds.
وليحرصوا على أن لا يظهروا خلافاتهم قدر الإمكان.
And they should be careful and diligent not to expose or to show their differences as much as they are able to.
فإن اختلفوا فليبينوا فليكون اختلافهم فيما يجوز فيه الخلاف.
If they differ, then let their differing be regarding things that it is allowable for them to differ within the Islamic law.
مع الحرص على عدم إظهار ذلك.
Along with carefulness and diligence not to show that.
فإن ظهر شيء من ذلك فليرشد الناس إلى كيفية الموقف الصحيح
If
من هذا الاختلاف.
Some of these differences got shown up, يعني the people got to know about them, then let them advise the people regarding how to deal in with their differences.
فانظروا مثلا إلى الأئمة الأربعة أبي حنيفة ومالك والشافعي وأحمد.
So look at the four imams, for instance.
فقد اختلفوا في مسائل.
They differed in issues.
لكنهم لم يختلفوا في أصول الدين.
But they did not differ regarding the foundations of the religion.
ومع اختلافهم كانوا يرشدون الناس إلى أن هذه وجهات نظر واجتهادات.
Alongside with the differences that they had, they used to guide the people that these are points of view belonging to them and differences in terms of putting the effort, اجتهاد, putting the effort to reach a verdict or a conclusion in the religion.
فلا يجوز لكم أيها المسلمون أن تجعلوا من هذه الاختلافات.
So it's not allowable for you, O Muslims, to make those differences of opinions.
أسبابا لتفريقكم.
Reasons leading to division amongst you.
فمثلا.
For instance.
هناك بعض العلماء يقول من كان متوضئا.
There are some scholars who say the one who has wudu,
فخرج من أنفه الدم,
and the blood came out from his nose, which is called رعاف.
بعض العلماء يقول لابد أن تعيد الوضوء.
Some scholars they say you have to redo your wudu again.
بعض العلماء قال لا تعيد الوضوء إنما تمسح فقط الدم.
Some scholars they said no, you don't redo your wudu, rather you just wipe away the blood.
هذا من الاختلاف الجائز.
This is from the differing that is allowed in Islam.
اجتهادات ووجهات نظر.
Positions based on putting the effort and just different views, different points of view.
فإذا كنت ستصلي خلف إمام.
So if you are going to pray behind an imam.
يرى أن الرعاف لا يبطل الوضوء.
Who is of the position that the blood coming out from the nose does not break the wudu.
فهو توضأ ورعف ثم مسح دمه وجاء يصلي بنا.
So he made wudu, then blood came out from his nose, so he wiped it away, and then he came and led us in prayer.
هل نصلي خلفه أم لا؟
Do we pray behind him or no?
ما الجواب؟
What is the answer?
نصلي؟
They said yes, we pray behind him.
من يقول لا نصلي خلفه؟
Who says we shouldn't pray behind him?
أنت ترى أن الوضوء باطل كيف تصلي خلفه؟
But you, the Sheikh said, you are of the view, for instance, that the wudu is nullified if blood comes out from your nose. So how do you then pray behind a person who had blood coming out from his nose?
الدين يسر. نعم.
The religion is easy, yeah?
نعم. هذا قول جديد.
So if you have knowledge, the brother said that you can find out, يعني, that this is not, you cannot pray behind him, then you don't. But if you are from the common folks, just pray behind him. The Sheikh said that a new.
شرحت لهم قوله.
نعم.
يعني إذا كنت عالما خلاص تصلي خلفه تصلي وحدك هناك. وإذا كنت لا تعرف فتصلي خلفه. هذا ما شاء الله قول جديد هذا.
If you are a scholar and you know that you can't, then you pray just by yourself there. And if you are from the common folks, just pray behind them. This is a new position.
والقول الصحيح هو ما قاله كل الإخوة هنا أننا نصلي خلفه.
The correct position is what most of the brothers said here, that we pray behind him.
لماذا?
Why?
لأن العبرة بما يراه الإمام وليس بما يراه المأموم.
Because what counts is what the position of the Imam is, not what the position of the مأموم, the one who's praying behind him is.
هو لما صلى هل يرى وضوءه صحيحا أم باطلا?
When he prayed, is he of the view that his wudu is null and void, or is it correct and sound?
يراه صحيحا.
He is of the view that
his هو في نفسه يصلي بوضوء أو بغير وضوء.
وضوء is sound. So himself.
هذا يعتقد.
What does he believe? He's believing that he prays having wudu or does not having wudu.
ويعتقد أنه على وضوء.
He actually believes that he has wudu, that his wudu is not broken. So then you pray behind him.
هكذا تجتمع الأمة.
This way the ummah, the Muslim ummah, will unite.
مثال آخر.
Another example.
هناك من العلماء من يقول من كان متوضئا وأكل لحم الجمل فيعيد الوضوء.
There are of the scholars who say that if someone was having wudu, then he ate camel's meat, then he has to redo his wudu. His wudu is broken, he has to redo it again because he ate camel meat.
وهناك من العلماء من يقول لا 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 تعيد الوضوء وضوءك صحيح.
And there are amongst the scholars who say do not repeat the wudu, your wudu is still valid.
فرأيت إمامك متوضي ثم أكل لحم الجمل وجاء ولم يتوضأ وصلى بك.
Your imam he had wudu, he ate camel's meat, then he came and he led you in prayer. We did not repeat his wudu.
فصلاته وصلاتك صحيحة لأنه هو يرى أنه على وضوء.
His prayer and your prayer is valid because he is of the position that his wudu is still valid.
لكن هل اختلف معك هذا الإمام في القبلة أين توجد?
This imam, is he differing with you about the qibla?
أنتم direction of the qibla. تصلون إلى قبلة واحدة.
Where is it? Or you pray to one qibla, right?
تصلون لإله واحد وهو الله.
You pray to one God and that is Allah.
تتبعون رسول الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو رسولنا الواحد.
You follow the messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He's just one messenger for us.
إذن على الدعاة إلى الإسلام أن يتعاونوا على الخير.
So it is upon the callers to Islam to cooperate with one another upon goodness.
ولا يختلفوا في الأصول.
They should not differ in the foundations of the religion.
وإذا اختلفوا في بعض الاجتهادات في الفروع.
And if they differ in some of the positions they take out of putting effort in the branches of the religion,
فليحاولوا أن لا يظهروا ذلك قدر الإمكان.
Let them try not to show that as much as they are able to, the differences that is.
وما ظهر منه يعلمون الناس أن هذا اجتهاد.
Whatever appears or shows of the differences, then they should teach the people that these differences are based upon اجتهاد. Everyone is putting his very best effort to follow the correct position.
فلا يجعلكم متحاسدين ومتباغضين.
So this way you will not turn into people who are envying one another, who have animosity towards one another.
قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
He said عليه الصلاة والسلام.
دب إليكم داء الأمم قبلكم الحسد والبغضاء.
The disease of the nations before you has crept into you. يعني slowly going deeply through you, and that is الحسد, envy, and البغضاء, hatred and animosity.
ثم بين خطورة هذين المرضين على الأمة.
He clarified the danger of these two diseases for the ummah.
قال هي الحالقة حالقة الدين. He أي said تذهب الحسنات.
It is the shaver or the clipper. It shaves, takes away. The Sheikh said it means the shaver here. Those diseases, they shaved off the religion, meaning they حالقة الدين
لا حالقة الشعر.
They shave off the religion. They don't shave off the hair, really. Those two diseases, they wipe out the religion, that is the deen of a person.
يعني الحسد والبغضاء
so
يذهب الحسنات من
envy
الإنسان.
And hatred will make your rewards, good deeds, go away, wiped out completely.
كما تذهب الموسى وتحلق الشعر.
Like the shaver shave off the religion.
فعلينا
like
أن
the
نكون
razor will completely shave off the hair.
فعلينا أن نكون متحابين.
So it is upon us to be to show love to one another.
حتى ندخل الجنة.
So that we will enter paradise.
قال عليه الصلاة والسلام.
He said عليه الصلاة والسلام.
والذي نفس محمد بيده لا تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا.
By the one in whose hand is my soul, you will not believe until you love one another.
أفلا أنبئكم بأمر إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم؟
Shall I inform you of something if if you do, then you will love one another.
أفشوا السلام بينكم.
Spread the greetings of peace within you.
الفائدة التاسعة والعشرون.
Benefit number 29.
إن فرعون طغى في الأرض.
Surely Pharaoh, he was a transgressor who was committed tyranny on earth.
ولم يؤمن مع أنه رأى آيات الله.
He did not believe, although he saw the signs, miracles.
لماذا؟
Why?
لأنه كان يظن أنه إذا صار مؤمنا ذهب ملكه.
Because he was of the position that if he believed, then his kingdom and dominion will be wiped out.
وهكذا كثير من الناس لا يؤمنون يخافون على مصالحهم.
Like that, many people, they do not believe, they are afraid for their own interests and benefits.
والعكس هو الصحيح.
While the opposite is the truth.
لأن فرعون لو آمن
Because فرعون, if he believed,
لبقي ملكه.
Then his actually kingdom and dominion will remain.
ولبارك الله له في ملكه.
Rather, Allah will bless his kingdom.
إذن على الإنسان أن يغلب مصلحة الدين على مصلحة
Then
نفسه.
Then the person must give more weight to the benefit, the religious interests, over his own personal interests.
فمن كان عنده أموال ولكن كان يفعل يأتي بها من الحرام.
So the one who has money but he is bringing this money from halal from haram sources.
فيقال له ابتعد عن الحرام.
He is told stay away from prohibitions.
فهو يظن أنه إذا فعل هذا ذهبت أمواله.
He thinks that if he did that, then his money will be gone, will be lost.
وهو لا يدري أنه لو صلح لبارك الله في أمواله.
He does not know that actually, if he is rectified and reformed, left the haram, then Allah will bless his wealth.
الفائدة الثلاثون.
Benefit 30.
إن الله تعالى لما أنجى بني إسرائيل من فرعون وقومه.
That Allah عز وجل when he saved موسى and his people from Pharaoh and his people.
كان عليهم أن يشكروا الله تعالى.
It was upon them that they should offer thanks to Allah.
ويزيدوا في عبادته وتحسينها.
They should increase their worship for him and they should increase perfecting their worship for Allah.
لكنهم لما خرجوا من إلى الشاطئ الآخر ونجاهم الله.
But when they went out to the other side of the shore and Allah عز وجل saved them from drowning.
وكانوا سائرين إلى أرض المقدسة.
And they were their target or their destination was towards the Holy Land.
في طريقهم رأوا قوما يشركون بالله.
On the way they saw people who are associating partners in worship with Allah.
يشركون بالله بشجرة يطلبون منها البركة.
They associate partners in worship with Allah يعني with a tree. They were asking and requesting from that tree.
فطلبوا من موسى طلب قوم موسى من موسى أن يجعل لهم آلهة كما لهم آلهة.
So the people of Musa, they asked Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام to have for them a god like those people, the idolaters, have gods.
فهذا جهل عظيم أن يترك عبادة الله ويطلب عبادة غيره.
This is a grave ignorance that they will abandon worshiping Allah and to ask and request to worship other than Him.
هناك من الناس من كانوا مستعمرين وكان مضغوط عليهم.
There are from the people those who were colonized and they were under pressure.
فلما حررهم الله وصاروا أحرارا في بلادهم.
When Allah liberated them and they became free in their countries.
بدلا من أن يطيعوا الله صاروا يعصون الله.
Instead of obeying Allah, they started disobeying Allah.
وهذا خطأ عظيم.
And this is a grave mistake.
لا يتوافق مع شكر الله سبحانه وتعالى.
This grave mistake does not agree, does not match what they should do, and that is to offer thanks to Allah. ربع ساعة للصلاة شيخ.
طيب. الفائدة 31.
Benefit 31.
إن قوم موسى عليه السلام أتعبوه كثيرا.
The people of Musa surely they made him عليه الصلاة والسلام very tired.
بكثرة الأسئلة.
By asking him too many questions.
وهم لا يريدون تطبيق ذلك.
When they don't want to really apply that.
وإنما كانوا يريدون الاستهزاء وتعجيز موسى
عليه السلام. Rather, they just only wanted to make fun, to ridicule him, and to put him in a situation where he is incapable.
ولهذا غضب الله عليهم.
This is why Allah was angry with them.
ولهذا علينا نحن المسلمين ألا نكثر من الأسئلة بدون فائدة.
This is why it is upon us Muslims that we should not ask questions excessively without any benefit.
وألا نكثر التدقيق والتجزئة لأشياء واضحة في الإسلام.
And we should not also go into minute exacting details about things that are clear in Islam.
فقد قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
For the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
فإنما هلك من كان قبلكم
For surely those who were before you they only got destroyed
بكثرة سؤالهم واختلافهم على أنبيائهم
By their excessive questioning and them going against what their prophets told them
فإذا أمرتكم بشيء فأتوا منه ما استطعتم
So if I command you to do something do of that whatever you are able to do
وإذا نهيتكم عن شيء فدعوه.
And if I forbade you from something, then leave it.
رواه مسلم.
Narrated by Muslim.
ما موقفنا من الأوامر والنواهي؟
What is our position from the commands and the prohibitions?
من خلال هذا الحديث.
From through this hadith that you heard.
الأوامر نفعل منها ما استطعنا.
Whatever Allah orders us to do, we do of those orders what we are capable of doing.
أما النواهي فنتركها كلها.
As for the forbidden matters, we leave them all.
الصلاة من الأوامر.
صلاة is from the commands and orders.
بعض الناس لا يستطيع أن يصلي بالوضوء فيصلي بالتيمم.
Some people they cannot pray making wudu, so they pray with tayammum, dry ablution.
بعضهم لا يستطيع أن يصلي واقفا فيصلي جالسا.
Some of them they can't pray standing, let them pray sitting.
إذن الأوامر so نفعل منها كل
orders,
واحد على قدر استطاعته.
The orders we do of them, each one of us according to our abilities.
أما النواهي فنتركها كلها لأنها سهلة الترك.
As for the prohibitions, then we leave them all because leaving those prohibitions is easy.
فمثلا الخمر من الأوامر أو من النواهي.
For instance, drinking alcohol, is it from the orders or from the forbidden matters
من النواهي
it is from the forbidden
إذن نترك الخمر شرب الخمر كله
so we leave we abandon drinking alcohol completely
بعض الناس يقول لا انا لا استطيع ان اترك شرب الخمر كله
اشرب Some people,
كأسا صغيرا مع فطور الصباح breakfast
I cannot leave drinking alcohol in totality I have to drink a little bit, you know, a small cup in the morning with breakfast.
وكأس صغير مع الغداء.
And a small cup also with the, you know.
وكأس
lunch.
صغير مع العشاء.
And another cup, small one, with dinner.
لا المحرمات نتركها
no,
كلها.
The prohibited things we leave them completely.
لماذا؟
Why?
لأن المنهيات يستطيع الإنسان أن يتركها.
Because of the forbidden, because the forbidden matters, everyone can abandon and leave them.
يعني ليس فيها تكلف للعمل بها مثل الأوامر.
They are not as burdensome as to do them. They are not as burdensome as the orders. They involve some, you know, effort.
فالأوامر فيها حركة لفعلها.
To fulfill the orders, you have to move and labor to do them.
والحركة تختلف من شخص إلى شخص.
And this movement to achieve the order differs from one person to the other.
ثم إن الله تعالى لا يحرم علينا شيئا إلا وفيه مضرة 100%.
Then Allah Azza wa Jalla, He does not forbid us anything except that it has harm for us. Either 100% harm.
أو فيها بعض الفوائد لكن مضرتها أكثر.
Or there is some benefits to it, but then the harms are far outweigh the benefits.
طيب. ثم كان هناك قصة موسى عليه السلام مع الخضر.
Then there is the story of Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام along with Al-Khadr.
التي قصها الله تعالى علينا في سورة الكهف.
Which Allah عز وجل narrated to us in سورة الكهف.
والقول الصحيح أن الخضر لم يكن أن الخضر هو كان نبيا.
And the correct position is that Al-Khadr, he was actually a prophet.
فتعلم نبي من نبي.
So a prophet learned from another prophet.
وأن العلم يؤخذ بالتعلم عن الذي يعلم.
And the fact we benefit from that knowledge is taken from a teacher who knows who will teach you.
وفيه تواضع موسى عليه السلام أنه تعلم من نبي ولا ومع أن موسى أفضل من الخضر.
And in this we benefit the humbleness of موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام, for he learned from another prophet, Al-Khadr, although Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was actually higher in status than Al-Khadr.
فعلى الإنسان أن يحرص على العلم النافع.
So the person should be careful and diligent to learn the beneficial knowledge.
ولو تعلمه ممن هو أفضل منه.
Even if he learns it from someone أقل منه شيخ.
يعني أقل منه نعم.
Even if he had to learn that piece of knowledge from someone who may be lesser than him in status.
وخاصة excellence. كبار السن.
Especially the ones who are older in age.
بعضهم إذا جاءه شخص مثلا داعية يعلمه وكان أصغر منه لا يقبل منه.
Some of them there comes a داعية a caller. And he calls, then if that caller was younger than him, he may not accept from him because he's more older in age.
فيقول ذلك الكبير أنت تعلمني أن هذا حرام وأنا أعرف هذا الشيء قبل أن تولد.
So the older person, he would say, you are teaching me that this is haram. I know this before you were even born.
فنقول له ممكن أن يكون هو يعلم وأنت لا تعلم.
We say to him, this old man, that maybe he knows and you do not know.
مثل أنك تذهب عند الطبيب.
Like you go to the medical doctor.
فيقول لك الطبيب إن القهوة هي سبب مرضك.
So the doctor says to you that the coffee is the reason behind your sickness.
فأترك شرب القهوة.
So completely leave drinking coffee.
فهل يقول له هذا الكبير أنا أعرف القهوة قبل أن تولد؟
So this older man, would he tell him, I know coffee before you were even born?
لا يقول له شكرا.
Rather he should say thank you.
ويعطيه المال.
And he gives him money too. He pays him.
إذن علينا أن نتعلم الخير ولو كان الذي نتعلم منه أصغر منا.
So we should learn what is good even if the one whom we are learning it from is someone who is younger than us in age.
المهم أن يكون على علم ومتيقن من علمه.
What matters is that he is upon knowledge and that he is sure of the knowledge that he has.
هذه بعض الفوائد من هذه القصة الجميلة.
These are some of the benefits from this beautiful story.
وهذه القصة تدل على صدق رسالة نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And this story proves the truthfulness of the message of our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هذه الفائدة 33.
And this is the benefit number 33 actually.
هذه الدقائق والتفصيلات كيف يأتي بها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي لم يقرأ ولم يكتب.
Those details and minute or exacting information, how is it that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم will bring such a thing when he never wrote or he wasn't reading or writing.
إنه جاء بها من عند الله.
He came with this information from Allah عز وجل.
فعلينا أن نتمسك بدين الإسلام.
So it is upon us to hold fast to the religion of Islam.
وأن نؤمن برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And to believe in the Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وأن نحبه.
And that we should love him.
ونكون على يقين أنه رسول الله حقيقة.
And be certain that he is the true Messenger of Allah in reality.
والحمد لله رب العالمين.
All praises due to Allah, the Lord of the worlds.
غدا إن شاء الله نأخذ قصة عيسى بن مريم عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Tomorrow, inshallah, we'll go through the story of Isa ibn Maryam عليه الصلاة والسلام. Inshallah, tomorrow, بإذن الله تعالى, صلاة العصر 5:30, and we sit with the Sheikh until صلاة العشاء. The last chance to benefit from the Sheikh, inshallah, tomorrow, as he is leaving on Monday. Inshallah, may Allah take him back safely home, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا. We see you tomorrow, inshallah. صلاة العصر 5:30 بإذن الله. جزاك الله خير.
كم بقي؟
خلاص ممكن يؤذن الآن ويقيم بعد. تفضل إن شاء الله.